See what it's done to the bottom of my John boat up there? It's really boogered it up. I gotta get this roller off. I got the two backboards that went right there. They really serve no purpose on this setup for this John boat. So obviously this trailer wasn't for this John boat. I got two 12-foot pressure treated 2x4s and they were kind of wet. And as they dried, they started to bend. But that's fine because the bottom of the boat kind of does that. So I think I'm going to be okay with it. But I got them all clamped down. I did that yesterday. I got the brackets off and the old boards off. The old boards only went to right here. I got the new bunks all secured down. So what we done was, so we took that roller off the front because that roller on the front wasn't tall enough for the front of the John boat to clear that U-bolt. And it was tearing up the front of the John boat. So now I gotta fix the front of the John boat. So what we done is I put a crossboard across to raise it up. I drilled through the frame, put lag bolts in the bunk boards. And back here on the middle support, I went ahead and put a board across there to raise the bunks up. And also drilled through the boards and put lag bolts in. And we got lag bolts in the back. So we got it painted with the Rust-Oleum dark walnut like we painted the trailer. So we're going to wait a couple days for that to dry really good. And then we got our Shoreline trailer bunk padding. And we're going to glue that down with the Roberts 6700 indoor-outdoor carpet adhesive. And then we're going to staple the bunk carpeting all on the sides and the ends. Okay, so it's been a week. And my boards have dried. And you know that front roller that was up there? I took it apart, put a new bolt in it, and greased it. And then I drilled two holes in the back there because I had holes for a bigger roller. And leveled it up. So I don't have to cut much off. It's only about a foot longer than my bunks, so that's gonna work out pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna spread the glue on, glue that carpet down, and I'm gonna staple it. So after you glue the carpet down and staple it, you need to put some weight on the top so that it the carpet will stick to it. So that's what I've done. I'll let that set overnight. So when you're stapling that carpet on after you put the glue on, it'll squish out and get on your stapler here and on the handle. So you need to take some Goo Gone or some Oops and you just soak it down and get that glue off, because it will ruin a stapler, especially when if it gets in the front here. So there it is. I set tackle boxes and toolboxes on it last night, and it is glued down. I mean, it's pretty nice. So there it is. So that should stop the bottom of my John boat from getting tore up. Now I gotta do a little fiberglass on the bottom and then repaint the bottom with this Duralex aluminum boat green. It's the M736. It's what I used on it before. So anyway, at least it's not gonna hit that U-bolt there, that bracket. So hopefully it's gonna work out. And with that roller there that I redid, I think it's gonna do pretty good.
It sure is a heck a lot better than what was on there. I don't think that trailer was for this boat to begin with. So, I think it's going to work perfect. That little roller is right to the edge so that it doesn't hit the back of the boards first. I think it's going to work out really well. All right, so for Tom's boating and fishing, repairing and messing around channel, I'm Tom Moore, and good luck to you.